Hi, this is Graham and I do hope everyone's having a great day. Today I have a product review for you and it's the Panasonic Lumix GWC-1 wide angle conversion lens for Micro Four Third camera lenses. It's been specifically designed to work with the H14E lens, that's the dedicated 14mm f2.5 lens, and the X-rated lens, the 14-42 PS14042E. The lens itself is made from plastic, but having said that, it's the durable plastic that Panasonic use for their lens mounts, and it's quite well manufactured. To use the lens with the respective lens you want to convert, you need to use an adapter. And you are provided with two adapters. One is a 37mm adapter, which is for use with the X-rated PS14042 lens. And the other one is a 46mm adapter for use with the H14E lens. To install the adapter, there's a bayonet on the back of the adapter which aligns with a bayonet on the lens system. There's a mark on the lens barrel which you align with a mark on the lens adapter. Install the two together and then turn the adapter counterclockwise until it clicks. At that point you will see two lines which are aligned together, and that indicates that the adapter is correctly installed on this lens. The lens then screws into the filter mount of the respective lens. So there's the lens installed on the 14mm f2.5 lens. The adapter itself weighs something like 78 grams, which is 2.5 ounces, so it doesn't add much bulk to the system, and it doesn't add much length either, if you can notice from the picture I'm showing you now. The magnification is 0.79 times, which converts the native 14mm to 11mm. So it does give you quite a considerable change in wide angle viewpoint. If you use anything with the 14-42 lens, Panasonic do state in the instructions that you should only use it at the 14mm end, as the lens has only been designed to cater for that correction. Obviously, if you're going to use it beyond that on that zoom range, it's better to take off the wide angle conversion and just use the native zoom of the basic lens. The only disappointing feature of this lens I found is the fact that there is no filter thread. And again, in the instructions, Panasonic do state that it will not take a lens thread or additional filters. For me, they've missed a trick. If you're a videographer, you'll know that you try to set the shutter speed to be twice the frame rate, and to do that quite often we employ neutral density filters, but with this system now there's no way of installing a neutral density filter. With the 14mm lens it was quite easy to install a 46mm filter or a filter with an adapter, but now we don't have that facility. So in my opinion, this is a bad step for Panasonic. We should have had a lens system which had a filter mount inbuilt. I think that applies to the other two lenses in this series, which is the macro lens and the telephoto 2x converter, again for this range of lenses. You are provided with a front and a rear lens cap, and a lens cap to install on the smaller of the two adapters, the 37mm one. The results are outstanding. I did expect to find a little bit more curvature of field, so that the centre would be more sharp than the outside edges, but I haven't found that in practice. And you'll notice on some of these pictures I've shot, the detail at the edges is astounding and matches that of the centre. I've shot lots of pictures with f2.5 all the way up to f11, and I haven't really noticed any aberrations on the outside edges of any of the pictures I've shot. So it just goes to show that if you get a correctly matched adapter lens to the prime lens, you can get some achievable results. In previous videos I've showed other wide angle conversion lenses, the Minolta 0.8, the newer 0.45 and the Digital King 0.7. Most of these are designed to work with the 17-55mm DSLR lenses, but I have adapted them to fit on compact digital cameras such as the Sony HX9V or the Sony HX20V. And especially the Digital King works quite well. The newer one has a lot of curvature of field and quite a few aberrations as well. So I tend to dismiss the newer one and either use the Minolta one or the Digital King when I'm using the compact digital cameras. I don't expect this one to work with those because it's been specifically designed for the 14mm range of lenses. I haven't noticed any additional chromatic aberration when using the adapter. I know the in-camera JPEGs are corrected for use with the 14mm lens, but it wouldn't know that there's a wide-angle lens attached to that lens, and you would expect to see some chromatic aberration. But I haven't noticed any, even on very fine tree branches. The results are outstanding. So there we are, that's my review of the Panasonic GWC-1 wide angle conversion lens for the Panasonic. It gets a 9 out of 10, it would have got a 10 if we'd have had a lens thread that I could have attached additional filters to. Well, that's it for the review. I hope you found that interesting, and of course if you don't already subscribe to the channel, please consider doing so, as you will be then notified when I upload extra tutorials or product reviews to my channel. So until my next video, thanks again for watching, have a safe day, and bye for now.